Getting a band together to play is hard enough already, but playing together on a video call? That might be harder than you think, and here's why. Every time you talk over a video call, it takes time for your voice to travel over the internet and for the people on the other end to hear you. That's called latency. We can tolerate it in conversation, but it makes playing music together almost impossible. And for jazz musicians, improvising is our lifeblood. Without other musicians to play with, there's no improvising. To play together, we have to hear each other at the exact same time, or at least perceive it that way. And it takes time for sound to travel any distance. But a study showed that in person, musicians can still play in sync up to 30 feet apart. Sound travels that 30 feet in about 30 milliseconds. Over a video call, it usually takes about 500 milliseconds, or half a second. Now this is what a 30 millisecond delay sounds like. It's there, but it's hard to notice. Now this is a 500 millisecond delay. Big difference, right? With that added latency, playing in sync becomes impossible. So if video calls are too slow, is there a way for musicians in quarantine to play together?
I remember when I was a teenager, I once tried to do like a little rehearsal with a bassist over the phone, and it's just like, it's hopeless, because you're getting at least half a second, you know, often over a second of latency, and it's just terrible.
Dan told us that a few weeks ago, another musician asked him if someone in Hawaii could play with someone in New York City.
Well, nothing can travel faster than the speed of light, right? This is like a basic tenet of physics. Nothing. And it does take light some time to get from place to place. And so I got like a little piece of paper out and I wrote down New York to Hawaii is 8,000 kilometers and light travels at 300,000 kilometers per second.
And if you do the math, it takes about 52 milliseconds for light to do New York to Hawaii round trip. And remember, for musicians to play together, they need latencies of 30 milliseconds or lower.
So at the end of the day, there is no possible way, unless literally the fundamental laws of physics change, that someone in New York could play in real time with someone in Hawaii in any kind of meaningful, like real rhythmic interaction type of way.
Okay, so it sounds like New York City to Hawaii isn't gonna happen. But Dan tweeted about this, and somewhere in the comments there was a beacon of hope. A link to a video made by another jazz tech guru, Michael Dessen.
As a musician, I compose and perform and deal with different kinds of technologies, but one area of my research is this networked music making, and it went from being a curious novelty for people to suddenly being an urgent necessity to learn about, so my phone's been ringing off the hook.
Since the early 2000s, Michael has been using an open source software created at Stanford University called JackTrip to rehearse and perform music remotely with other musicians.
What it does is it moves audio data specifically in a very efficient way at very high quality, meaning you can capture really high quality sound recordings and move them immediately, very quickly, across networks with the minimal travel time. One of the things we found was that up to around 500 miles, if the conditions are right, if we have enough speed, we can actually play in time together with no perceivable latency.
So once Dan learned about JackTrip, he had to test it for himself with his friend Jorge Roeder, who was quarantined a couple miles away.
Neither one of us had improvised with another human being in over 6 weeks. And, you know, remember, we're professional jazz musicians. We're used to doing this, like, all the time. And so we were, like, in withdrawal. And I don't think we fully realized how much in withdrawal we were. Man, we started improvising together, and it was just like tears were coming out of our eyes, practically. You know, when we stopped, it was just like, oh my God, that feels so good. I've missed this so much.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
After Dan's own success with JackTrip, it was off to the races. He started teaching other musicians about it to build a network of people who can play together while they're still in quarantine. So with all of these musicians playing in sync over the internet, will we be in the new age of virtual concerts?
Will it actually replace live performance? I hope not, because it's totally next level. When you're in the same space together and you can talk afterwards and you can see the expressions on people's faces and you have that palpable feeling of you know, if everything's going right, of everyone breathing together at the end of a phrase, you know, that's just amazing. And I think if there's one thing that music is for, is to bring us together, and live performance in the same physical space does that more than anything else.
So playing online isn't quite the same as being in the same room, but for now, while concerts continue to be postponed and musicians are keeping a distance from one another, technologies like this might have to do.